They're big, they're bad, and they're trying to take control of every aspect of our lives. It's the government! I totally understand why people don't trust the government. Historically, they're always up to something shady, and it seems like anyone who runs for office lacks the levels of empathy that it takes to care for another person, and all they want is to have more money and more power. So today, we're going to be putting on our tinfoil hats and diving into what the government could be hiding. Hello, Top 5 Scary fans, I'm your host, Chaitor. And for today's list, we're going to be counting down the top 5 scary secrets the government is hiding. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. And stick around until the end of this list because I'm going to be asking all the horror fans out there a unanswered horror movie question. And without taking any longer, let's get into this list. Coming in at number 5, we have secret experiments. This is nothing new. The government has been up to all sorts of secret experiments. If we go back through the 20th century, we have things like MK Ultra. This is when the CIA and the American government was obsessed with mind control and trying to find some way to implement it into warfare and interrogations. Some of the things they would do is take someone and put them in isolation for an undetermined amount of time and see if they would break mentally and start giving up information. They would mostly do this on prisoners that had no idea they were part of an experiment. Wow, that definitely sounds ethical, but that isn't even the most notorious part. What the experiment is really famous for is when the CIA would use LSD, that is a hallucinatory drug known as acid, to try and control people's minds in interrogations. They would give people doses of LSD without them knowing and put them under extreme questioning. Once again, they would do this to people who had no idea they were being experimented on. Eventually, the tests were all stopped and a lot of the information on the studies was released to the public. Some people think that this was just a last attempt at trying to find a way to control people, but other people are convinced that the government was successful in finding some way to take control over people's minds. So this begs the question, what kind of secret studies or experiments is the government conducting now? We think that they have learned their lesson from their mistakes, but it's the government. They are the masters of doing things that cost tons of money and that are extremely unethical. This is their bread and butter, baby. They could be doing tests on artificial intelligence without us knowing, working on making a living, thinking AI that has the ability to feel emotions and make complex decisions. Not only would this be terrifying, but the tests they could be running could be seen as some sort of torture in the future. Coming in at number 4, we have receiving data from social media companies. When it comes to data and information, we know that the government can't be trusted. They will find some way to get your stuff. It doesn't matter what your data is. Do you spend 2 hours a day looking at memes? The government wants to know about it. Do you have a habit of ordering McDonald's delivered right to your house, even though you live 5 minutes away from the nearest Donnie's? The government wants to know about that too. Am I just sharing with you my bad tendencies that I should probably stop because they are holding me back? That could be a possibility too. But we already know that the NSA was looking at all your phone calls, all of your emails, and collecting all of your data back in 2013. And you think just because we caught them, they were gonna stop? No way! Then Facebook got caught for selling data, and you don't think that other major companies aren't doing the same thing? Data is the most valuable thing on the planet right now, and there's no way that the government doesn't have their hands in the pot somewhere. That was the big problem with TikTok. It's Chinese owned, so America didn't want their data flying out to another country from the American people, but they are perfectly fine with it staying in the hands of the American people, probably because they're getting a piece of it. Coming at number 3, we have secret weapons. Especially in America, where the military funding is through the roof. Who knows what sort of technological advancements are happening behind closed doors? I don't think we will ever know what's going on until they want us to know. Places like Area 51 have stayed secret forever, and even when there was supposed to be a massive raid, which just turned out to be a bunch of people hanging out in the desert for a good laugh, none of the secrets have leaked out. Well, not none of them. There are some people who have claimed to work at Area 51 and have leaked some secrets. Most famously is Bob Lazar. If you follow the content I'm a part of, then you will for sure have heard me talk about Bob Lazar before. He is known as the man who worked at Area 51 and then started spilling the beans about what was going on there. There's a documentary about him on Netflix, and he has been on Rogan talking about some of the stuff that he worked on. Now, Bob has never claimed to work on any sort of weaponry. He says that all the stuff he worked on had to do with flight. He was working on a new type of spaceship that can move faster than anything we could comprehend. Basically, the way he described it is these secret spaceships use what's called a gravity reactor, which bends gravity around them that lets a ship move at an insane speed. It's a form of propulsion that was thought to be impossible, and he says that it's not only possible, but it uses something called element 115 to happen. This is the substance that is used in the gravity reactor. Even though Bob has never worked on anything to do with weaponry, he did mention that there was some sort of evidence of weaponry testing and design using element 115. What on earth could that look like? What does a gravity gun or gravity bomb do to a person or an entire city? Bob worked with the government in Area 51 back in the 80s, so who knows what kind of advancements they have made since then? The American government could be hiding a weapon that could have the destructive capabilities to take out an entire country or blow up the moon. Or if they could shoot nukes faster than the speed of light, there wouldn't be a lot of time to get shelter and protect your people if that gets fired at you. Well, let's hope we never have to experience something like that, because I don't want the world ending right now. There's also things like Project HAARP, a system of radio towers in Alaska that apparently have the ability to control the weather and even cause things like powerful earthquakes. Imagine you could weaponize the weather, cause lightning and hail to decimate your enemy. It would be like they're in the movie Geostorm. You could make the terrain too cold to fight on, or make the weather too erratic for your enemy to grow crops to feed their troops. They would quickly be bending the knee to your godlike power. There's also rumors that Project HAARP has the ability to send out a low frequency signal to a large area and cause an entire population to pass out. You could incapacitate an entire city. All right, coming in at number two, we have aliens. I mean, we were just talking about Area 51, so it only makes sense that we talk about aliens for a little bit. The government has known about aliens for a long time, and they just started telling us. They need to open the door and let us know all the things about these little green dudes walking around, because I want to become their friend and go on a crazy space adventure. Now, if you want to go really deep, you could say that aliens are running the government, and that is why they won't spill the beans. But that's not the vibe we're going for today. What I'm going to focus on is the fact that we know the government has been hiding the truth about aliens, because they recently declassified a lot of alien files and started showing us UFOs and the fact that they are real. They even released government footage of a UFO. There was a legit flying saucer caught on camera just floating around, and no one reacted at all. Mind you, the world was kind of on fire at that point with all the protests and coronavirus, but it's still crazy and no one cared. But here's what I'm thinking. There's no way that they told us everything. There's no way that the little bit of footage and documents that were shown to us was everything they have to offer. And the stuff that they're hiding is probably the best stuff. I bet they have a full alien language mapped out that you can learn on Rosetta Stone. And coming in at the number one spot, we have Jeffrey Epstein's involvement with the government. This is a massive conspiracy that is still in the forefront of most news stories. It is the wildest story to hit America mainstream media in years, and really, it's just getting started. If you don't know what's going on, let me fill you in. Jeffrey Epstein was a mystery multimillionaire. No one really knew where he got his money from. He was associated with some of the most rich and powerful people in the world, people in the film and television industry, high-ranking government officials, even members of the royal family of England have connections to this guy. Jeffrey Epstein was a known human trafficker, and he had an island which we suspected was a place where rich and powerful people would fly to partake in human trafficking with victims that were not of legal age. I can't go into detail on what would happen there, it is too inappropriate for this channel, but when you hear private island, human trafficking, not of legal age, rich and powerful people, I think you can piece together what was happening. And if you want things in more detail, just literally Google Jeffrey Epstein. Oh, and I forgot to mention that Jeffrey Epstein had a plane which was nicknamed the Lolita Express. That alone is extremely disturbing. When you start to go into the flight logs on this plane, you start to find a lot of wealthy people. Many of them were high-ranking government officials. People like Bill Clinton, Prince Andrew, Tom Pritzker, a member of one of the richest families in the United States, and former president of Colombia, Andreas Pastrana. The list goes on and on. Then one day Jeffrey Epstein is arrested, and it looks like he's going to have to stand trial for all of his horrible offenses and spill the beans. But before he gets the chance, he mysteriously dies in jail. It seems very convenient that someone who could probably ruin so many rich and powerful people died out of nowhere. So the question is, how deep do the Epstein ties go into the government? And if you thought the story was over, oh, we are far away from the end. Epstein's right-hand woman, Ghislaine Maxwell, who was the person who would find many of these people to take to Epstein's island, is now under arrest and set to stand trial. And in a strange turn of events, the president was questioned about her being in jail, and he said, "I wish her well." What does that mean? Who knows? All right, everyone, that has been our list, and I want to ask you guys an unanswered horror movie question before I let you go. And my question today is, what happened to Walter in Alien Covenant? All right, everyone, that is it. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Until next time, I've been your host, Jade Arena, and keep enjoying this scary content.